Ben stole a short punch. We're awaiting the start of round number 7 here at Caesars Palace in Las Vegas. Panamanian flags were in evidence during that 6th round, as you saw the replay of that action, responding to their champion. There are many Puerto Rican fans here, too. 7th round, Duran and White, the Jesus and Red.
This nation's looking for one punch. You can't do that with Duran because he can hurt you off the next shot, Joe. In other words, he's got to box his way into punches, and that's what he didn't do that last round. That's why Duran took charge real good in the last round.
Right now, Duran is the more relaxed fighter. He's slipping punches, getting in better position to punch. He Jesus has to reach him. When he reaches, he pays for it. Duran won his title back in 1972 over Ken Buchanan. Jesus in 1976 over Ishimatsu Suzuki, the WBC crown.
You know, just the first time showing a little wear and tear on his face, he's got bruises under both eyes. And he's looking the weary of the two.
Yes, he is. I tell you, he needs a big punch, and he's got to land one big one to really get back in this fight.
Well, either guy can, you know, knock each other, either guy out, you know. And they're that kind of punches. I can see the record shows it. They're both punches.
That was a vicious exchange. A good right hand to the body by Duran and a good left hook by DeJesus. DeJesus, his nickname is Dita, D-I-T-A. They call Duran Mano de Piedra, Stoneheads. I tell you, Duran's eyes look like two hot coals. I wouldn't want him looking at me like that. They're so intense.
Trying to set something up, Joe. He's beating his playing his way right now, looking to set up a good punch, set up off a jab. This is the only way he's going to do it, because Duran is a disciplined target with his sliding in and out. Very smart jumping play.
Well, they have Duran. DeJesus moving more this round, but moving's not going to win him the rounds. He's going, as you say, he's going to have to nail him with a good punch. He's going to have to set him up and get rid of one. Right? Duran is in control. He's able to set his own pace. Very relaxed. Look at those eyes, Angel. Approaching the end of round number 7. Less than 30 seconds remaining now. Let's get on to the good move there, Joe. He's got to do more of that, in and out, side to side. Otherwise, see what he does. Now he's playing cat and mouse with Duran. And Duran's going to his pattern. Duran's got to pick up momentum. Otherwise, he's going to be in trouble. That's right. That's just like a chess game. That's what it's all about. Final seconds of the 7th round. Roberto Duran conducting business. How would you describe it, Gil?
Those eyes are tight, like two hot coals. It's very, very intense. It's almost self-hypnosis. He doesn't see anything but DeJesus in that ring right now.
Will Clancy, Angelo Dundee, and Tim Ryan at ringside in Las Vegas, Nevada. We're in the 8th round of the World Lightweight Championship. If it doesn't end in the draw, we will have an undisputed lightweight champion of the world.
Esteban is trying to set up a pattern, Gil. He's trying to keep Duran off balance, keep him off balance where he can't land a big punch. And he's trying to do it by moving.
I tell you, Duran has been trying to reach with that right hand a little too much. I think he ought to go to the body with a little more. In each of the last two fights, DeJesus had Duran on the floor of the 1st round. We have not seen anything approaching the knockdown punch so far by either fighter. The floor in the title fight in 1974 to knock DeJesus out the 11th round. Do they look strong to you at this point, Gil, Angelo?
They're both very strong. I think they're ready to go all night long. I think they're playing a good fight for themselves, but the thing is, they got to establish where they're going to dominate the fight. No one's done that to me.
You indicated you think Duran is in control.
Well, yes, you see that last body punch? That's going to help him in the late rounds.
Hit him in the body and the head will die by itself. Yeah.
Gil. He gets his legs together when he gets in the clinches. You notice?
That's right.
Them up together. He's got a rebound. They're together now.
Right. That left foot belongs forward. It belongs between the other fella's legs. You get those feet even, you have no support, and you can't punch.
Now, Duran, you know when he did that, Gil? Left with a right hand, come back with a left foot. This is remarkable. He can do that all night long.
Well, that's the one point that reminds me of Rocky Marciano. Marciano used to throw a right hand and miss you by 2 feet, and they come back and knock you dead with a left hook.
Under 36 guy can do the
same thing.
There it goes there, Joe. See it? Switching his feet. Into a southpaw stand. Final seconds of the eighth round. Duran and the Aces really banging on each other.
Switches his feet now. When he gets him close, he's got both feet together now, Esteban. That's no good. He's off balance. He's got to play one foot behind the other.
De Jesus and Duran awaiting round 9. Scheduled for 15. Aaron Esteban De Jesus bringing it in to his corner.
Double champion.
Ricky Dekettingham handing the
opposite.
They're screaming for De Jesus to use a double jab. One jab and you can count it. If you use a double jab, you can keep the guy off balance. That's when you're worried about when you're fighting a punch. You tell your fighter to double the jab or triple it even. But don't throw one and hang out there.
I noticed in the corner that time, Gil, that Esteban took a nice swig of water. It means that the guy's getting a little tired. He's starting to drink the water instead of burgers spitting up.
Let's see if he pays attention to his corner. They told him to double his jab up. Now, so far this round twice, he's only thrown single jabs and got counted. Let's see if he doubles it up.
The ace is on the right of his feet. Right
the right front.
What is trouble with that, Gil? When he throws a jab out there and lays it out there, the man has a nice left hook to the body, off that jab. He's got to slip that jab, let it go, and back out. Don't stay there.
That's right. It's stick and move is the name of the game.
Well, this is Gil Clancy, manager of Rodrigo Valdez, the middleweight champion, Angelo Dundee, manager of Muhammad Ali. Trainer of Muhammad Ali, more precise and accurate.
Yes, sir, I like to see that right hand. That sets up everything else.
That's where Esteban doesn't see the right hand. That's a very good punch to the body. I was waiting for him to do that. The last 2 rounds, he was reaching with that right hand. Now he's putting the way up along.
Cute he was the way he walked around. That's a sign of a good fighter, an experienced fighter.
Well, the two champions are trying to say who is the undisputed champion. We'll find out tonight.
I tell you, that was a great right hand uppercut by Duran, but De Jesus has taken these punches. He doesn't show any signs of wobble.
I don't know about that, Gil. He got hurt the last shot. He's starting to show wear and tear around the eyes right now.
I'm looking at the legs, Ange. They haven't shook yet.
That's at a minute remaining in the ninth round.
I tell you, as you pointed out, that Duran is a cute fighter. I mean, Esteban is a sharpshooter, and he just can't seem to hit Duran. Can't hit him with a solid punch.
Well, what impressed me, Gil, he's unmarked. This is a mark of a good fighter. Takes a good punch, he slides with a punch.
Under 30 seconds to go.
Right now, I have Duran in complete control of the fight. Esteban is going to have to make a big rally to get back in this fight and retain this championship. Yes, I have Duran out front. I have Esteban winning about 3 rounds, the rest all Duran.
Final seconds of the ninth round.